When you need advice, come to Ben and Kelly. It's group therapy on 99.7 DJX.
All right, so Kelly, describe what group therapy is for someone who may be experiencing this for the very first time.
Well, this is a safe place, free of charge, where you can come and discuss an issue you're struggling with in your life, you need some advice on. We've got a lot of really nice people listening who want to help.
Yes, absolutely. So, Josh, we're changing his name, okay? And I have, I've convinced Josh, to come on with us, but the stipulation was we needed to use a voice disguiser.
Okay.
All right. So,
all right.
Josh, good morning.
Good morning.
So the title of your message to us kind of sparked curiosity. And so, thank you so much for allowing us to dive into your situation and, just go ahead and walk through like what you sent us.
Yeah. So, I mean, now I'm a little embarrassed, but whatever. You know, after about like 10 years mm-hmm. of marriage or so, right? My wife and I, we're getting ready to be separated, right?
Sorry about that.
Yeah, I mean, you know, thankfully, like, the separation is amicable, right? It's sure. mutual. We both want it. So okay. at least, like, there's no, you know, ill will towards each other, right?
Uh-huh.
And then we don't need children either, so that makes things a lot more straightforward and easier.
Yeah, sure.
And, all right, I'm just going to say it. Like, I want you guys to listen before you start roasting me, okay? Remember, I've been married for almost 10 years, and then we were dating before that. So I've been with the same woman for a pretty long mm-hmm. time. And so my question is about dating, right? Or, like, getting back out there, so to speak.
Okay.
So, you know, to put it one way, like, my wife and I, like, we both agree that we've been roommates for a few years now, right? Like,
I get that. Okay.
Like, we would both say that we've been lonely for a while, and, you know, I'm ready to dip my toe back into those dating waters. Like, I want to get out there, and I want to respect her, and I'm not proposing mm-hmm. to do, like, right now, like, go out dating right now, go get on Tinder right now. I'm going to wait until it's official, until we're legally mm-hmm. separated. But I also, like, I don't want to wait months and months either, right? Like, I'm ready, man.
Okay, so you're, like, feeling like you've already, you and your wife have already been living separate lives for so long, even though you've been together. Okay, I get it. All right, I'm following.
Yeah. No, that's it exactly. That's exactly. So, like, I guess I'm asking, right? Is there some sort of, like, socially acceptable time period? Like, I don't want our friends to think it's indefinite, or I don't want to think that it's infidelity. And also, I'm not ready for the funny looks I know I'll get from friends, acquaintances, from dating too soon. You know, you always hear about that guy, right? He's, like, already dating somebody, and then they think that, like, they were dating all along throughout the marriage. You know what I mean? And, like, I also, you know, I'm thinking about it from the other side. Like, I don't want to weird out any potential dates.
Oh, yeah. Like, right? Especially, it's like, oh, so you just got out of a 10-year relationship. And, yeah, no, sure, I can understand why that would scare someone away.
Yeah. And then the most important thing is, like, I don't want to hurt my wife's feelings, right? Well, my ex-wife's feelings by getting out there, like, too soon, you know? Like, so, I don't know. Like, I was kind of hoping that you all or your listeners, if you guys knew of any guidelines for this sort of thing.
Wow. Well, I mean, Josh, I've got to be honest, like, you know, at first read of the message you sent us and before talking to you now, you know, got the feeling it's like, gosh, you know, this guy already had a foot out the door. He was already, like, looking at women and things like that. And it doesn't sound like to me that is the case. And so it sounds like you do have a respect for your, you know, soon to be ex. But, yeah, I mean, we've got a ton of people checking in already on text. So if you want to, you know, hang out, listen, and, you know, maybe we can steer you in that right direction.
That's awesome. Yeah, because, like, you know, is it a week, is it a month, is it 3 months? Like, what is it, right? What's that magic time period? So that's great.
Yeah, cool. I mean, it's tough any way you look at it, obviously, the ending of a relationship like that. But I appreciate you letting us handle it, and we'll see what we can do.
Awesome, guys. I appreciate it.
All right, thanks, Josh.
So Jennifer is like, listen, just get out there, move out, get settled, and start swiping white. Right, LOL.
just swipe right on everything. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Leah's like, 1 month, I think, is enough time. It's long enough for you to gain control of your inner emotions. Think of what you would want out of a relationship with someone. If you're still worried about hurting your wife's feelings, be an adult, have a conversation with her rather than hiding the fact you're ready to move on. I'm sure she's going to support your choice as well as you supporting hers to get back out there. Encourage each other since this was agreed to mutually.
Right. All right. Group therapy in his real name, but he finally came on with us with a voice disguiser and he's still married. However, he's separated and living apart from his life from his wife in the same house. Been doing so for a long time and they're going to get a divorce, going to split. But now he's like, hey, I want to get back out there. I've been lonely for a long time. What's an acceptable amount of time to wait before I do? Because I could see from a potential, you know, person that he's dating's perspective that wait. You just left your wife last week? Okay. I don't know if this is right. So yeah, he's just coming to us and going, is there like a formula for this?
Yeah. And the biggest thing is, I mean, their split is mutual. So his, you know, soon to be ex-wife had to get out there too. And a lot of people, I think, are really commending him on his honesty through this whole thing and the fact that he does want to make sure that he carries on respectfully. Dee Dee said, 6 years ago, I divorced. Kicked him out 1st of March, went on a date April 26th. Divorce was final May 15th. Now I'm engaged to the guy I went on that date with.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, Kate said, I was in the same situation of living with a roommate. Very lonely. I did not wait long after our separation to get back out there. I hadn't intended on anything really serious, but I ended up dating this man who is now my husband of almost 7 years. You'll know when you're ready, and that's all that matters.
So I want to know, is there anybody who has been the other person who, you know, your partner, like a week after the separation was final, like went out on a date with you? And like, how did that feel? Were you okay with that? Like,
here's the thing. They have come to this decision mutually. It's amicable. So she's probably going through a lot of the same things that he is as far as, you know, the loneliness that they've been living with and, you know, probably ready to just start over. And maybe I think if he just sits down and tells her, like, this is where I'm at with my emotions, this is what I'm looking to do, where are you? And how do you feel about it? I think he just really needs to be honest and talk to her about that. Like, are you in the same place as I am? I want to make sure that I respect you and your feelings.
Right.
But this is how I'm feeling.
Stephanie rolls in and says, hey, just be advised. I did have a short rebound relationship in between, you know, my split from my ex and my now husband. So just be prepared for that.
And then there's some other warning messages about, hey, just be prepared. There may be some women that you go out with that might be a little wary of the fact that you're separated.
But then Denise,
not divorced yet,
rolls in with, hey, why not try and go out on a date with your wife? Maybe rekindle what you had.
It doesn't sound like that's where they're at.
I don't know.
Again, given the fact that it's a mutual and amicable split. Now, Sassy Matt, we can always depend on him to roll in here and says, Sassy Matt here, it's never too early. But first, things are a bit different than 10 years ago. He needs to do some thumb exercises to condition his swiper. Then download Tinder and only swipe right. No southpaws here. And by doing so, the opportunities will come rolling in. Trust in the sassy.
Trust in the sassy. He's giving himself a slogan. All right, I like that. All right.
There you go. There's a lot to sift through. And hopefully Josh will just, you know, again, I think it's going to start with having an honest conversation with his soon-to-be ex. And, you know, just make sure they're kind of on the same page. And that way he can just figure out what feels right.
All right. Well, hopefully we helped keep us updated on that situation there. And if you've got a comment or you want to listen back to his call, you can at Facebook at Ben and Kelly Show.